Talking about the January series, it was for the bulls and so was the last day, how they defended the 11,000 mark. Remember, we touched lows of 11,009 and we are 70 points higher from the day's low. So flat closing, but definitely a good series, the best series that we've seen for Nifty and Bank Nifty since March 2016. Well, Sensex too closing the day with cuts of almost 90 points, but Bank Nifty is closing in the greens with gains of almost 40 points. Let's see how the broader markets perform. Second straight day of more selling coming about from the broader markets. Nifty mid-cap free float index down almost 200% and the small cap index too closing the day with cuts of 1%, and so was the case for the BSE mid-cap index. Let's look at the Sensex constituents then. This is the screen. Well, we can see more of red, but let me start off with the gainers first. ICICI Bank, what a strong run this stock has had in the last 5 to 6 trading session. Top gainer on Sensex. L&T is the other one. Coal India, Axis Bank. Clearly, today was the day for the private banks. We've got HDFC Bank, you had Kotak Mahindra Bank, Axis Bank, all of them, including IndusInd Bank, are closing the day in the green. On the losing side, you've got the PSU Major, State Bank of India, cuts of over 5%. The other losers for the day were Adani Ports. Dr. Reddy's number disappointed the street, and you've got other heavyweights like ITC, which was down, and Maruti, ahead of its numbers, is closing the day in the red, Pradeep.
Let's look at some of the key movers over last 1 hour or so. You have India Glycol on the positive side that has moved up quite a bit in last hour of trade, ending the day almost at day's high. Also, sugar stocks inched up after a sharp correction. Actually, this could just be a bounce that will last for a day or two. We don't know what is the direction here, but Dwarka Sugar has moved up with some improvement in sugar prices. Hotel stocks that we talked about during the show as well, Royal Orchid and Hotel Leela, are two key beneficiaries where we saw significant buying interest coming in last hour. And Adani Enterprises was yet another key gainer in the last 10-15 minutes of trade actually. Some of the key losers would include UPL that lost quite a bit, also Syndicate Bank and PNB among PSU banking stocks. These two kept falling even in last hour of trade, and you can see both have ended the day very close to the day's low. Ajanta Pharma, the numbers came out and the stock fell, and also Indocount Industries figured among key losers. Neeraj.
Well, so this is the picture at close. There's a bit of a dichotomy between the Sensex and the Nifty, mind you. The Nifty is flattish, the Sensex about 0.4% lower in trade. I could attribute it to maybe, some stocks not present on the Nifty, not present on the Sensex, present on the Nifty as well. But those are on the losing side, the likes of UPL, etc. Just the clutch of gainers fairly lower on the Nifty as well. The contributors list should come up on your screen. I would presume that some of the banks have actually salvaged the picture for the Nifty, and which is why ICICI Bank and L&T, both of which surged in the dying moments of trade. At this, Kotak Mahindra Bank was probably more steady, but banks helping salvage some of the position. The losers list dominated by State Bank of India individually, and as we said, IT today, large cap IT in particular, but actually mid cap IT too, select names came off, but large cap IT in particular didn't have the best of days. The volumes, and yes, the F&O volumes would be higher. The key is to figure out if the cash market volumes have looked high too. Wow, this is I don't know about the BSE cash, but the NSE cash and the NSE F&O, these would be the highest volumes that I've seen in a really, really long time. Navneet, I don't know what your sense would be.
Yes, Neeraj, it was in that range of 42 to 43,000. So I guess you're right. It is the highest figure that we've seen. And also for the NSE F&O 17, last figure that I remember was the highest was around that range of 15 to 15 and a half.
Yeah, so BSE cash is obviously not the highest, but NSE cash, NSE F&O, these are extremely high volumes that we've seen in the session today. Well, you have to say that participation has gone up. I don't know if it's the run-up to the budget or otherwise, but participation on the indices, both on the cash and the F&O side, has certainly moved up in this series. I think we've seen many days of extremely high participation. The heat map, a lot of red on the screen. UPL and SBI dominating trade. We've spoken about this at length. Indiabulls Housing is something that we haven't spoken about, but that is topping the charts today. And some gains to iShares, which is some respite really to shareholders there, and Ultratech Cement, Vedanta within the commodity space doing okay. But all in all, an interesting kind of a week. We have scaled new highs, have pulled back a little bit as well, but you would probably be happy with the kind of performance that select mid caps have given. Just that Volatility had shot up for most part of the week. I'm guessing in today's session, India Weeks would have just spared some of those gains.